Hey everyone, welcome to today's video on how to import Elementor templates. This guide will cover how to import Elementor templates and Elementor template kits. So the difference between an Elementor template kit is that an Elementor template is a pre-designed layout of a specific page or section that contains images and buttons and can be easily inserted into a page or a post. An Elementor template kit, on the other hand, is a collection of templates that are designed to work together to create a complete website. Kits often come with additional design elements such as fonts and icons and may include additional functionality. So you're going to need 3 to 4 things to import your Elementor template. You're going to need a WordPress website, you're going to need a template, you're going to need the Elementor plugin, and you may or may not need the Elementor Pro plugin. And this will really depend on what widgets and functionalities that your templates are leveraging. So for example, a pro widget is the contact form. If you want to use an Elementor template that contains a contact form, then you would need to upgrade to Elementor Pro. But the import process itself only requires you to have the Elementor plugin. So first, let's go over how to import an Elementor template itself. What we're gonna do is we're gonna come over to templates, we're gonna click import templates, and then we're gonna drag and drop our Elementor page or section, whatever, just the template. So we'll click import now. And there you have it. So it really is that simple. All right, so now we're gonna go over how to import an Elementor template kit. For this, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to Elementor and then go to Tools. We're gonna go to Import and Export Kit, Start Import, and drag and drop our template kit file. Then click Next, Next, and now it'll just take a bit to load. All right, close this. And now you can see here that I am having some pages, and I didn't show you this in advance, but it was originally blank and the kit imported these. And depending on how your kit is set up, you may or may not see the pages here. However, you'll always see them, more likely than not, you'll see them in the templates section. So if you go to templates and then all. So now all of the things that I imported are right here. So there you have it. That's how you import an Elementor template kit. All right, so now that we've imported your templates, you're probably wondering how do you use them? How do you get them onto the page? Well, there's 3 ways to do that. You can add it directly to a page, you can embed it into a page, or you can assign it to a page. So let's talk about when to use each type. So you'll directly add a template to a page when it's a section or a page that's really for one-time use only, such as a homepage template. Now you'll want to use the embed feature when you want to use the same template consistently across multiple pages. So for example, a contact form, you'd want that to look the same most likely across multiple pages. Third way is to assign it. And the best practices for assigning a template is for your blog post template, your archives pages, and your 404 pages. So let me show you how to do each of those. All right, so let's go ahead and create a new page. So I'm going to start by showing you how to add a template directly to the page, and then I'll show you how to embed it. So to add it directly to the page, what we're going to do is we're going to click the little folder icon, and then we're going to go to My Templates, and then we're going to find the template that we're looking for. In this case, I'm looking for, where is it? My Call to Action section. All right, so now that I have this on my page, there's a couple things to note. If I make changes on this page right now, it's not going to reflect back on the template itself. So for example, if I change this background to purple, if I were to pull this template in onto another page, it wouldn't be purple. So I'll show you how to edit the template if you want to do that a little bit later, but for now, just keep that in mind. When you're adding templates directly to a page, the changes that you make to it aren't reflected on the template itself. So now let me show you how to embed a template. I'm gonna delete that, and then I'm gonna go to the plus icon, click the single, and then I'm going to search for the template. Okay, and now it's asking me to select the template, so I'm gonna say CTA. Give it a chance to pull in. Let me go ahead and save this draft. Maybe it just needs a chance to refresh. Okay, so see here how it is just within a small frame. Obviously, that doesn't look good, and we can fix it. So the way that we're going to do that is we're going to select the section and change the content width to full width, and then we're going to change the columns gap to no gap. Perfect. So let me just show you how these two templates look virtually the same, but the only difference is the underlying way that they're pulled in. Cool, so what I have now is I have a template that's embedded to the page, and I have a template that's added directly to the page. And let me show you a little bit more about what that difference looks like. So if I right click and click Navigator, I can see I have my section, my column, and then a template. Whereas if I come down below, I have a section and the actual pieces that make up this template, and I can totally change it and do whatever I want. So that's how you add a template directly and how you embed a template. Now, I mentioned before, I want to show you how to edit a template. What you'll do here is you'll click the template and you'll just click Edit Template. And so let's change this background to purple. Can't miss that. And so now that I've modified the template itself, when I come back here, now this is going to be purple. There you go. I deleted it, but if I had left that other template that I added directly, it would still have the blue background, not the purplish pink color. All right, so the third and final way to add a template into your pages and incorporate it is using the assignment method. And as I mentioned before, this is best for blog posts, archives, the 404 page. So let's jump into it. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click the hamburger icon, exit out. I'm gonna go to templates, I'm gonna go to all, and I'm gonna find the template that I wanna assign to my blog post. Single, my archives page. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click edit with Elementor. Okay, and as you can see, this looks like an archives page. And then all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come down here and I'm gonna select display conditions. So now not every template type that you create will have the ability to set display conditions. So it will of course work for archive pages and 404 pages, but for example, you can't add display conditions for a section. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click the dropdown, and it's already set because that was the way the template was created, which was great, but I'm just showing you in case you come across a template that isn't properly assigned. So in this case, the template is properly assigned to the post page, which is great, it's what we want, but I wanna show you this in case the template you're working with isn't assigned correctly. So what I'll do is I'll just click the dropdown, and it's showing me all of the different assignment options that I have for this particular template. So in this case, it's already working for our post archives, which is great. So nothing really to change there. And there you have it. Now, one thing I wanna add is if you are interested in working with this template, I do offer it for free on my website. You can go ahead and download it to get started. Here's a quick look of what it looks like. And it is, of course, mobile responsive. We even have the e-commerce shop built out where you can swap out your own digital products to start monetizing your blog. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions, please comment below and check out the blog post that I have written associated with this, where I'll be building out frequently asked questions and keeping you guys up to date with the latest value. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I look forward to seeing you next time.